Good afternoon. My name is K. Ramesh Babu. I am working as Associate Professor in the Department of Science and Humanities. So today I am going to say a few words on classification of optical fibers. We know that optical fiber is glass or plastic material which will be as thin as human hair and designed to guide light along its length. So that is an optical fiber. And also we know that the parameters of optical fiber are given by acceptance angle, acceptance cone, numerical aperture and fractional refractive index. These are the parameters associated with an optical fiber. And we know that for a better performance of a fiber, the numerical aperture should be very high. Now in this class, I want to tell about the classification of optical fibers. We know that in a fiber, light rays travel along the different paths. But during their passage, some light rays will interfere constructively and some light rays will interfere destructively. As a result, in a fiber, there will be a limited number of paths along which light rays reinforce each other. So these allowed paths of light rays are called as modes of propagation. In a fiber, there will be a limited number of modes of propagation. The number of modes of propagation supported by a fiber depends on the diameter of a fiber. If diameter is large, then more number of modes of propagation will be present in the fiber. If diameter is less, then there will be less number of modes of propagation in the fiber. So based on the modes of propagation, we can classify all the optical fibers into two groups. One group is called as single mode fibers. And the other group is called as multi-mode fibers. So based on the number of modes of propagation supported by a fiber, the optical fibers are classified as single mode fibers and multi-mode fibers. First of all, I will tell briefly about the single mode fibers. So I will talk about single mode fibers. In a single mode fiber, the core diameter will be very small. Therefore, it supports only one mode of propagation. In a single mode fiber, the core diameter will be very, very small. As a result, it will support only one mode of propagation, and that mode of propagation will be along the axis of that fiber. So the cross section of that single mode fiber I will show here. So this is the core region of the fiber and this is the cladding region of the fiber. So here the core diameter is very small when compared to the diameter of the cladding. So that is about this single mode fiber cross section. Now all the fibers, they are actually distinguished by a parameter called as index profile. This index profile is simply a graph that is drawn between refractive index taken on y-axis and the distance from center of the core taken on x-axis. For example, if you draw the index profile for this fiber, the index profile will be something like this. So this region corresponds to core region, and we know that the core region will have a refractive index of n1 and the cladding will have a refractive index of n2. So the core region will have a refractive index of n1 and the cladding will have a refractive index of n2. Now if you take a graph between, the refractive index taken on y-axis and the distance from center of the core taken on x-axis, that graph will look like this. So the graph of the index profile of this single mode fiber will be something like this. Here on the y-axis I have taken the refractive index and on x-axis I have taken the distance from center of the core. This is the distance, this is the center of the core and I am drawn graph between refractive index on y axis and the distance from center of the core on x axis, and this horizontal portion corresponding to the refractive index of L1, constant refractive index of L1 in the core region, and this constant value of graph, it corresponds to refractive index of L2, that is of cladding. So this is the index profile of this fiber, and here you observe that this index profile is in the form of a step. This is like a step. Therefore, the single mode fiber is also called as a step index single mode fiber. It is also called as a step index single mode fiber. So it is also called as a step index single mode fiber. Now we'll see the side view of this fiber. So I can draw the side view like this. So this is the core region of the fiber, and this is the cladding region of the fiber. So this is the core region, and this portion corresponds to the cladding region. Now here I will show the single mode of propagation, that is along the axis of the core region. So this is the mode of propagation in the single mode fiber. Like this, we can denote the cross section of the fiber, the index profile of the fiber, and the side view of that fiber. Now we will see the advantages of this fiber and disadvantage of this fiber, and also we see the application of this fiber. First of all, I will tell you about the advantages of this fiber. This fiber will have very high bandwidth. It will have very high bandwidth. The bandwidth will be of the order of gigabytes. So that is the gigahertz. The bandwidth will be of the order of gigahertz. That is why it will transfer very high amount of data. So that is the first advantage of this particular fiber. High bandwidth is the first advantage. And the second advantage of this is the losses of the fiber. The losses of the fiber are very less. So there will be bending losses and other losses will be there in the fiber. So that type of losses will be very less in this case. So these are the advantages, and there are many disadvantages also. The disadvantages are like this. The first disadvantage is the numerical aperture of this fiber will be low. It will be very less. So numerical aperture is indicating the light gathering capacity of the fiber. So the numerical aperture of this fiber will be very less. That is one disadvantage. Second disadvantage is fabrication is difficult here. Fabrication of fiber is difficult because the core diameter is very very small. So to fabricate a single mode fiber, it will become a difficult process. And then coupling of fiber is not easy. Coupling of fiber is not easy. This is also a drawback of this fiber. And further, it is very costly. Cost of this fiber is also very high. So these are the disadvantages of this particular fiber. Like this, we can talk about the advantages and the disadvantage of this fiber. Now we'll see the one important application of this fiber. Generally, this type of fiber is used as underwater cable. This type of fiber is used as an underwater cable. Okay, so that is one important application of this particular fiber. Like this, we can talk about a single mode fiber, that is also called as step index single mode fiber. Now we look at the second category of fibers. They are multi-mode fibers. The second category of fibers are given by multi-mode fibers. These multi-mode fibers, they are further divided as step index multi-mode fiber. These are further divided as step index multi-mode fiber and graded index fiber. graded index fiber. The graded index fiber is abbreviated as green fiber. Now we try to understand the difference between step index multimode fiber and graded index fiber. Okay, so first of all I will tell about the step index multimode fiber. First of all, I will tell about step index. Multimode fiber. So it is similar to the step index single mode fiber. The only difference is in the core diameter. In this case, the core diameter will be large. When compared to the single mode fiber. So the core diameter will be somewhat large here, and because of the large core diameter, it will support more than one course of propagation. Then I will look at the index profile of this fiber. The index profile of this fiber will be something like this. So the index profile of this fiber I am showing. So the index profile will be similar to that of a single mode fiber. So the only difference between single mode fiber and multimode fiber is in the core diameter. So this is the index profile of this fiber. Now we will see the side view of this fiber. So for that I will take the core region. So this is the core region and this is the cladding region. And in this fiber there will be a mode of propagation along the axis that will be present in all fibers. Along with this fiber mode of propagation, there will be several other modes of propagation which will be something like this. So here I showed three modes of propagation. One is along the core axis, then this is the second one, and this is the third one. Like this we can show the modes of propagation supported by a multimode fiber. Since its index profile is in the form of a step, this is called as step index multimode fiber. Now we look at the advantages and disadvantages of this fiber. The advantages of this fiber are like this. The advantages are something like this. The first advantage is the numerical aperture is high here. In this case, the core diameter is large, therefore the numerical aperture will be very high. And here the fabrication is easy. Fabrication of this fiber is easy. That is second advantage. The third advantage is coupling of the fiber is also easy. Then it is very cheap when compared to the single mode fiber. So I will say that it is cheaper when compared to the single mode fiber. So these are the advantages of this particular fiber. And it also gets some disadvantages. The disadvantages are like this. The bandwidth is not high here. In this case, the bandwidth is low. So the bandwidth is low. Because of this problem, it cannot be used for long distance communications. And the second problem with this is losses. The losses also very high. The losses are high in this case. So these are the disadvantages of this particular multimode step index fiber. And the application, I can say like this. I will tell one application of this fiber. These fibers are used as data links. That means to transfer data from one system to the other system, we use this type of fibers. So that is one application of this particular fiber. So that is about the this fiber. And I want to tell very briefly about the graded index fiber. Okay, anyway, I will stop here. Thank you for patience hearing. Thank you.